Mate, disappointing loss last week against the Hurricanes after what's been a couple of really solid performances by the boys.
Yeah, very disappointing from our perspective. The team has been feeling as though we've been building nicely and went over there with a bit of confidence, and unfortunately that was well and truly shattered. Having said that, the Hurricanes typically are a team who can score some amazing tries and get a lot of momentum. Unfortunately, we weren't able to get back on track. So it was disappointing, and likewise, we did suffer a fair few injuries as a result. So, but the mood's been positive. We're really looking forward to playing at home this Friday night. A big challenge for us playing against the Brumbies, who are at the top of our conference. So a lot of things to be excited about.
Going through some of those injuries, do you have a chance this week? Or?
Yeah, so mainly in our backs. Yeah. So Lockie Mitchell, I think he's no good at all. He suffered a pretty big concussion. Mark Girard, on the other hand, he looked probably worse, but he may well be a good chance to play. So very fingers crossed for him. Obviously, we've got training today, and then likewise, captain's run on Thursday. And if he goes well, then hopefully he'll be playing as well.
It's just going to be a process, isn't it, of still you're still a relatively young team, and this inconsistency is just something that's going to stick around for a little bit longer?
As much as it pains us, I guess that's the reality of where we're at the moment. We are working tirelessly and really hard on improving, but unfortunately, being a new team, that consistency can sometimes fall away. We certainly had a lot of it last year. We've been reducing that this year, but obviously from the weekend, let's hope it was a bump in the road.
And you come up against the might of the Brumbies this week, mate. Always a tough ask, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. They're a team that have just played some great football together this year, playing well as a unit. A lot of guys, I think 8 or so of their guys have been selected in the Wallabies training squad, so they'd be full of confidence and wanting to, I guess, step their authority on this match. So from our perspective, we love being back at home. We love playing at AAMI Park. We get tremendous support. Our members are just amazing. They're so vocal. We can't wait to play there. You really like playing against the best at the moment. The Brumbies are the best in our conference, so it's a great challenge.
Likely to get your first run on of the year this year, this week?
Yeah, I'm very excited to be getting my first run on. It's been a long time coming. Certainly, the way that things were heading in the pre-season, I would have laughed if you had said that it would have been this long until I got my first start. But injuries are weird, and this one's been a very tough one. But I've thoroughly enjoyed getting back out on the pitch with the guys. Obviously, last weekend was a tough one, but other than that performance, you know, the team has got a lot of belief in what we're doing and that we're heading the right track. And I can't wait to start with the boys.
But what have you been doing off the field, Junior, in terms of captaincy and stuff like that since you've been injured this year?
Well, you do as much as you can with the knowledge that you're not going to be out there in the weekend. So trying to help as much with the guys playing in the back line, likewise with doing analysis on the opposition team that you're playing. But at the end of the day, you've got to hand it over to the playing group, and they've got to take it and do the business on the field. So it's a tough situation to be in. One that you don't envy your players to be in either.
Is that frustrating in that situation?
Yeah, it's extremely frustrating. We love playing rugby. That's what we're here for. And when you can't do that, it is frustrating. But typically, I've had my fair share of injuries, and typically you sort of know roughly whereabouts you stand and when you'll hopefully be kept returning. In this instance, it wasn't the case. It just kept on keeping on and grinding away. So that, from my perspective, was more difficult than normal. But having said that, getting back into the group and the way that the guys are performing, the mentality, the belief in what we're trying to do with this club, it's been really positive. And again, I'm really excited about running out with the team this Friday night.
Will you be getting captaincy back with the runouts, or will you leave it with Gareth? Do you know?
Well, again, that's been another really impressive thing from my perspective, is the way that Gareth has led the team. He's a fantastic bloke, first and foremost. He does everything right and prepares so well for the weekend, and he goes out and puts it out on the pitch. And the guys have really responded to his leadership, so that's been great. And if I am captain this weekend, I'll certainly be keeping Delvey in a real strong leadership role with that forward pack.
Five guys on the training squad for the Wallabies is a fantastic result for such a young club, and what it sort of says to everyone else out there is you can be a young player in rugby union and you can come to the Rebels and still not have your international career curtailed.
Yeah, it's probably something that we haven't really focused on too much because we have been trying to review, and the weekend was rather disappointing, and likewise a short turnaround into this match. But the fantastic thing for our club to get five guys named in that Wallaby Tranon squad, and in particular, Cooper Vuna, Cade Neville and Hugh Pyle, all uncapped players getting an opportunity to go into the Wallaby ranks. It's a fantastic thing for them, first and foremost, but also a fair positive feedback for our club that what we're doing is heading us in the right direction.
In regards to George Gregan, I'll ask you about him. He's just been selected by the ARU as a statesman, one of seven statesmen from each of the eras, and he's representing the 2000s, obviously a guy you know really well. Just a couple of words on Georgie.
Oh, well, couldn't be more apt for George Gregan. He's exactly that and more. He's been an unbelievable contributor to the game of rugby for many, many years, and he's held in such high regard and a statesman. So fantastic news for him. From my perspective, I learned a tremendous amount playing with him, and also learning from him as a leader as well. He was just a fantastic player, great bloke, and just probably the most professional player that I've ever had contact with. So good stuff.